everybody. In today's video, we will be discussing about forms of cybercrime. After watching today's video, you will be able to describe cybercrimes based on the various forms. Let us first understand what computer forensic is. Computer forensics is the practice of collecting, analyzing, and presenting data in a way that it is legally admissible. Technological advancements have made it easy for people to store and access a huge amount of data related to a variety of information across diverse fields. A major proportion of our vital information and data is stored in computers and data storage units. Cybercrime, by nature, is an act of crime committed using technological aids such as computers, data processing devices, applications, and programs. Cybercrimes are becoming more prevalent these days because of the relative ease of access to data and the internet, of course. A cybercriminal can create a lot of damage and is a major security risk to various economic, defense, and national institutions. Of late, cybercriminals have joined the ranks of international terrorist groups, drug cartels, smugglers, illegal armed dealers, and organized criminal units. Now let us see the types of cybercrimes. Intellectual property theft. Theft or fraudulent access or usage of a company's created intellectual property or data by illegal or fraudulent means. Intellectual property theft is a serious crime, but it can be prevented. Stealing intellectual property is quite easy. All one would have to do is copy someone else's content, ideas, product or innovation, etc. for their own benefit. The victim would have already done the work, but the culprit would reap the profits. For example, Sharad, who is an author, wrote a story and put it up on his blog, which was easily lifted up and published elsewhere by a cyber theft by posting it as his own work and earned a lot of it for his story. IP theft can also cost people their lives, job, damage to the reputation of the original maker and the counterfeited product. It can cause material and mental harm, harassment, and even result in the spread of organized crime. CDs, DVDs, fashion design clothes, pharmaceutical supplies are all duplicated and counterfeited. Organized criminals are involved either in counterfeiting processes or in the distribution of counterfeiting products since they can make high profits out of this trade. Industrial espionage. It refers to the act of stealing, copying, or reversing engineering of another company via illegal technological means. It is often seen in automotive and technological-based companies where a significant amount of money is spent on research and development. Fraud and forgeries. It refers to the act of cheating or deceiving someone for a monetary gain. Technological aids like phishing, website spoofing, and card cloning, etc. are used in this crime. Money laundering. The money earned via fraud and forgeries cannot be used directly by cybercriminal. He or she needs to use a launderer, so it cannot be traced back to the original source. Laundering is done via the online route, creating and spreading viruses, trojans, and worms. Malicious-minded programmers create such codes and programs which wreak havoc in the target sector. They may be sent via emails, fake links, and other data transmission methods. Cyber squatting. It refers to the act of illegally occupying a website or a web page. Cyber stalking and bullying. This crime refers to the usage of email, social media accounts, and other portals to harass or malign or cause trouble to the target. Computer hacking. Hacking is a serious cyber crime. It can cause maximum damage to the target and is in the bane of all data and information security personnel in the world. Any electronic device, website, or a program having the capability to transmit, process, and receive data can be hacked if its working methodologies and protocols are known. From drones to banks, no place is safe from the hacker. Cyber terrorism. Terrorism has evolved from the AK-47 and RPG wavering pickup truck riding terrorists to anonymous people who use technology to further the terrorist agency's cause. Many e-terrorists employed by the terrorist groups consist of radicalized computer programmers, data processors, or hackers who spread havoc using bits and bytes. Email cybercrime. email has emerged from the world's preferred form of communication. Emails can be used to steal an individual's personal data, money, and peace of mind, as contents ranging from virus to death threats can be emailed to the target. Emails can also be used to carpet bomb a target, preventing his system from working correctly. Legal solicitation. The act of soliciting sexual and physical gratification via technologies means has been termed as a major cybercrime by various governments across the world. The perpetrators of said activities are believed to be based in the Baltic zones of the internet, the dark web, to carry out their activities. Identity theft. In today's digital world, a person's life can be measured in terms of bytes and bits. He or she may have created a means of identification and access. Cybercriminals can use fraudulent means to access this information. The data can be used for fraudulent purposes, for implicating someone else for their crimes. Let us have a quick recap of what we just discussed. Cybercrime can be categorized as a crime against individuals, properties, and governments. Various types of cybercrimes include financial fraud, forgery, email-related crimes, cyber-stalking, etc.